Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about the features and examples of phylum Coelenterata and phylum Genophora. In this class, let us discuss about the characteristic features of the next phylum, that is phylum Platyhelminthes. The members of phylum Platyhelminthes are commonly called as flatworms. The members of phylum Platyhelminthes are commonly called as flatworms because their body is dorsoventrally flattened. Hence they are called as flatworms. Then Platyhelminthes are usually endoparasites. That means they are present inside the body of human beings and other animals. Parasites are the organisms which are dependent on another living organism for food and shelter. Endoparasites are the parasites which are present inside. Endo means inside the body of human beings and inside the body of other animals. They are bilaterally symmetrical. The members of Platyhelminthes are bilaterally symmetrical. That means when a body can be divided into identical left and right halves only in one plane, then it is called bilateral symmetry. Platyhelminthes body is bilaterally symmetrical, or they exhibit bilateral symmetry. And they are triploblastic. Having three embryonic germ layers, such as outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm, and inner endoderm. Triploblastic. Then they are oscillomates. Oscillomates means absence of body cavity between gut wall and body wall. Body cavity is absent between gut wall and body wall. That condition is called oscillome. Animals possessing oscillome or animals in which body cavity is absent are called as oscillomates. And they exhibit organ level of organization. They show bilateral symmetry, they are triploblastic, oscillomates, and exhibit organ level of organization. Whereas the phylum Coelenterata and Genophora exhibit radial symmetry, tissue level of organization, and they are diploblastic, but Platyhelminthes are triploblastic, exhibit organ level of organization, and they are bilaterally symmetrical. Then parasitic forms. Parasitic forms contains hooks and suckers. Hooks are helpful for the attachment of Platyhelminthes to the body surface of host. For example, this is a host, and this one is the Platyhelminthes. This Platyhelminthes possess hooks. Hooks are helpful for the attachment. It is helpful for the attachment of the Platyhelminthes to the body surface of host. Whereas suckers are helpful to suck or to absorb or to obtain the nutrients from the host. Hooks are helpful for their attachment, whereas suckers are helpful for the absorption or for sucking the food directly from the host, mainly through their body surface. They absorb the nutrients or food from the host through their body surface. Then In case of platyhelminthus, specialized cells called flame cells are present. These flame cells are helpful in osmoregulation and excretion. Osmoregulation and excretion. In case of platyhelminthus, osmoregulation and excretion takes place by the help of specialized cells called flame cells. By the help of specialized cells called flame cells, osmoregulation and excretion takes place in case of platyhelminthus. It is very, very important for 1 mark. Excretion is nothing but the process of removal of waste from the body. Osmoregulation is a process by which the pH of the body fluids is maintained. That means it is a process, by the help of this process, salt level will be balanced. Level of salts will be balanced by osmoregulation process. Osmoregulation and excretion both takes place by the help of specialized cells called flame cells. Then sexes are in case of platyhelminthus, sexes are not separate. Sexes are not separate. That means they are hermaphrodite. Sexes are not separate. They are hermaphrodite. Means single organism only possess both male and female reproductive structures, or single organism only able to produce male and female gametes. That condition is called as hermaphrodite. We are unable to differentiate the male platyhelminthus and female platyhelminthus. Then fertilization. Fertilization is internal. Means fusion of male and female gametes takes place inside the body. Internal fertilization. And development is indirect. Indirect type of development. Then some members of platyhelminthus, like planaria, shows or they have the capacity of regeneration. Planaria have the capacity of regeneration. Regeneration is a type of asexual reproduction, in which the organism has the ability to produce the lost parts. Planaria shows regeneration. Means planaria is able to produce the lost parts. That process is called regeneration. So these are the important features of phylum platyhelminthus. Examples: Taenia, tapeworm, Taenia or tapeworm. Then Phasiola, liver fluke, and one more is planaria. You might have seen the structure of tapeworm. Tapeworm, like this. And liver fluke means in here hooks and suckers are present in their body. Liver fluke. This is about phylum Platyhelminthus. The next one is Aspergillus. Aspergillus.
Well-developed muscular pharynx.
elementary canal contains well developed muscular pharynx. Then, areas of asthenicus. Removal of the waste. Removal of waste or excretion. Removal of waste or excretion takes place through the excretory tube. Excretory tube having excretory pore. Excretory tube is present and the tube, excretory tube is present, that tube contains excretory pore. Pore means hole. Through that excretory pore, removal of the waste, removal of waste takes place from the body. Then sexes are separate. In case of asthenicus, sexes are separate. Whereas the platyhelminthus, in case of platyhelminthus, sexes are not separate. But in case of asthenicus, sexes are separate. Separate means we can identify as a male asthenicus and female asthenicus. We can differentiate the organism as male and female. Sexes are separate in case of asthenicus. We can differentiate the individuals into male and female. And here, female asthenicus or females are longer than males. Females are longer than males. Females are longer than males like this. This is female and this one is male. Females are longer than males. This is female roundworm or asthenicus. This is male. Like this, we can identify the male and female asthenicus. Not only by this reason, other differences are also there. By seeing that differences, we can identify the male and female asthenicus. Then fertilization. Fertilization is internal. Internal fertilization takes place. Means fusion of male and female gamete takes place inside the body. Internal type of fertilization. And development may be direct or indirect. Development may be direct or indirect. Means some members of asthenicus shows direct type of development, whereas some other members shows indirect type of development. So these are the important characteristic features of phylum asthenicus. The next one is examples. Examples of asthenicus. Examples include ascaris. Ascaris. Vachalia. Ascaris is an ascaris which causes the disease ascariasis. Ascariasis. Vachalia. Vachalia is an ascaris which causes filariasis or elephantiasis. Vachalia bancrofti. Vachalia bancrofti. Species name is bancrofti. Vachalia bancrofti is a asthenin which causes filariasis or it causes the disease elephantiasis. The leg of the patient looks like elephant leg. Hence the disease is called elephantiasis or filariasis. These are two important examples of asthenicus. Other than this, you can write rhabditis. This is about phylum Ascaris. In the next class, let us discuss about the next phylum, Annelida and Arthropoda. Thank you.